Alright, what's up, fishing family? So, you, as you may or may not know, which you obviously don't, I did get InShot Video Editor, and I have been learning how to use it. It's pretty easy, but it's, you may have got a CDA notification about the 100 subscriber redraw. When I tried to do it the first time, and I uploaded it, I accidentally picked their email, and it uploaded to their account, and now I couldn't fix it, and I had to wait, and I had to, re-download it and get all the information back again. But we're just going to make a super simple video, super short, and that's just going to be reviewing the product I use. I'm going to give a few shout-outs. So the shout-outs need to come first. First shout-out goes to Billy Kid. Go get him to like 40 subscribers. He's at like 5, I believe, right now. Go subscribe to him. He's an awesome channel. Also, go subscribe to the Fish Magnet. It's either Fish Magnet or Fish Magnets. And then the Fish Magnets, too. Also subscribe to them. Also subscribe to Puddle Walkers Outdoors. Get him to like 600 subscribers or more. He might actually be at 600. Get him to like 1,000. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe to this channel, like the video. But I'm gonna be reviewing some of my products today. So, first thing I use is the Lewes Laser SG1 Speed Stick with that nice handle, split grip. It's really nice. Feels good, you can put it under your armpit and just get that good hook set. And then the Speculations of the Rod are really cool. This is a medium heavy power, fast action. The line weight is 12 to 25 pounds. I took that very seriously and only got 20 pound braided line. And the lure weight is 1/4 of an ounce through 1/7, and the that's like the minimum, and then the max is 8 ounce, which I doubt it's actually 8 ounce. Because I don't think there's a lure that is over 8 ounces. That's a lot, man. Anyway, the lure that I like to throw on this is a medium heavy power. So it's good for Texas rigs, light jigs. As you can see, it bends a little bit, but it's got a super strong plank. I like to fish square bills on it. It works really well. You don't need a glass composite graphite, even though I want one. That's the KVD, or the Strike King KVD 1.0. Got that really cool color. It's super, super natural looking. And, really cool. You fish this around cover, laydowns, grass, like, patches. Like, if you have a bank of grass, cast it down the edge, reel it back, and you're, like, sure to get a bite. At least one of those casts. There'll be a link to this. This retails at about $6.50. But it's a really nice square bill, really hard to break, honestly. Really sharp, and, yeah. The reel is the Lewes Xfinity Speed Spool, 7.51 gear ratio, just to tell you my line, 7.51 gear ratio. And then, the braided line I'm using is just Bass Pro Shops brand, kind of an off-brand, 20-pound braided line, and this reel is amazing. I'll give it a cast, just to... You'll hear it, because it's a pretty loud reel, but it's really nice. You know, I might just try to... I'm going to cast it a little bit and show you. It's like a... I believe it's a quarter ounce, maybe a little bit less. It didn't really actually say how much it weighed, to be honest. But it's a pretty light lure. Really not... I mean, it's meant for bait casters. It's fine. I just wouldn't throw it a lot on bait casters. I'm just kidding. Of course I would. Anyway, we're going to cast this one time. Just one time. Well, maybe twice, but just gonna... Oh, that was a bad idea. Well, I wasn't really looking at the bait catcher that time. I was kind of looking at you guys. But, I feel like I made a catch. Dang, I'm stuck. I'm gonna go on a second.
That was a bad idea, guys.
I didn't want to make a super long one because my videos are pretty boring to watch. Because especially when I make them like 16 minutes long. And, I just wanted to say, the videos that I have tips on, those tips really didn't come from my knowledge. They came more from other videos that I, well, gained knowledge from. I don't really know the names of most of the videos anymore. I kind of forgot the titles, but, it's not very specific. It's just, you know. Well, I'm kind of tangled up here, guys, but, if you're enjoying the video, please do subscribe to the channel. If you like the video, go hit the like button, because it really helps me come out here and make more videos for you guys, because I know at least most of you enjoy the videos. They're not exactly the best quality or the best editing or anything like that, but they're okay, like. But that's pretty much the end of the video. The shoutouts, like I said, go subscribe to all those guys in the beginning of the video. Told you about. Go subscribe to this channel, please. And, oh, and one more thing. I did want to just show you some fish snacks. Was wondering about these. These are the old crankbaits I used to use. I did catch one fish on it. It took a really long time to catch a fish on it. But, this is cotton cordell. Crankbait. It's a little bit lighter than the KBD crankbait, but these are okay. But they have a lot of very like vibration wobble. It's kind of hard to tell whether you got a fish or not. And yeah, pretty much to end it. And I also took a Puddle Walker's advice and got a little Booyah Buzz bait in that cool color. Nice one. Sounds a lot like a Whopper Plopper. Let me see. I probably didn't hear that, but, anyway, getting this video for today, I'll try to link some of this gear down below, if you want it. Got this at Cabela's the other day, and, I will see you in the next video, guys. Oh, I'm sorry, one more shout out, or two more, to Den Boys Outdoors and Outdoors with Eli, or Eli Outdoors. He made a new channel. See you later. Give me some elbow.